Darah-Dandoa forces have claimed victory after U.S. troops have retreated from two engagements near the... released an official statement on their strategic withdrawal from the small skirmishes on... of Springfield, Texas, after the non-voluntary smallpox vaccination. Health workers could not divulge...
They should tell us what they know. It's our lives.
Dramatic footage from Television Free Indonesia showing Darah-Dandoa leader Suwadi Sadono apparently engaged in battle. It remains...
There's too much noise on the line. I'm not sure we'll be able to connect you to Sarah before we land.
We'll have the agency file on Pandora tomorrow, ready by the time you touch down. You're right. It's Sadono's insurance policy. If he misses a phone call, the virus gets released. We're vaccinating Springfield, Texas. But until we know how many other pox boxes there are, and where, Sadono is a glaring tripwire. We're going to have to tiptoe around him.
Did Grim write these smallpox flash notes?
Yeah, she's a poet in her own way. But she makes an interesting point. We slip up in Indonesia, and those images could be illustrations of anywhere in America.
I'm sorry, Fisher. I can't get Sarah on the line.
I don't know what I'd say to her anyway.
Refinery, Kundang, Indonesia. April 12th, 2006, 1512 hours. Shriel intercepts Sadono's communications. Pandora Tomorrow is the code phrase for Sadono's insurance policy against US attack. He makes daily secure phone calls to undisclosed US locations, delaying release of the smallpox virus one more day. If he is killed or detained, the virus will be released within 24 hours. Intercept Sadono's Pandora Tomorrow call in order to locate the virus.
This is going to be a complicated mission, Fisher. We're running it in cooperation with Displaced International, so your old friend Douglas Shetland will be local.
Good. I can work with Shetland. What's Shetland doing here?
A ghost army operation. He'll give you the brief.
Now, before we talk to Shetland, let us go ahead and read some of the data. Okay, we just have one thing. Agency file on the Kundang camp. Golden Triangle. Okay, Golden Triangle, I think it's like a triangle of drug trade. Made connections with the Golden Triangle heroin trade in the early 90s. When he was still a thug on the streets of Caribbean. On the streets of the Caribbean, I think. In 1996, he put them to work offering the Darah-Dandoa's Triple D's services for security for smuggling operations in the mountains. With the CIA pulled Triple D funding in 1998-99, Sadono doubled his invested time in the heroin business and multiplied his profits tenfold. Another variation of Sadono's particular idealism, I see. The Kundang camp is a madly lactating cash cow and packed with more armed, angry men than a Texas barbecue. I wonder who wrote this last line. It's funny. But, this sort of reminds me of what happened with the Taliban, the US, you know, funding them to destabilize the region, and when they succeeded, and the US stopped paying them, they sort of retaliated against the US. So, yeah, anyway. Let's talk to Shetland.
Howdy, Shetland.
Fisher! My God, old man, you keep turning up in unexpected places. I'd hope the next place we met would have been stateside. I'd like to buy you a beer, see how Sarah's doing.
Let's leave home where it is. What's this ghost army business?
Psyops, a distraction.
What's my part?
Your handler should have your objectives. For my part, Sadono's plane in the yard near the village needs to be sabotaged.
Since I was going to be in the neighborhood anyway.
Much appreciated. I've got a dozen displaced snipers around the camp. You won't see them, but you better believe they're there.
Right then. So before we head over to the zipline here and start, essentially ziplining down, I would first like to save here. And then, of course, since we have a 3-alarm limitation, we're going to try and exploit it as much as possible. diversion gas, smoke grenade. And let's go with the sticky shocker for now. We also have like a shaft grenade and a frag grenade. I wonder what the shaft grenade does. Anyway, for my first act, I will be shooting the first guy that comes out of here. I think there's somebody in there that comes out. Yes, right there. I hope he's in the shadows. If he's not, well, that's not really my problem.
Is somebody shooting?
Most likely, yes. Good, good, good. Now let me go ahead and adjust your bodies there. Actually, let me just go ahead and use this handgun here. Take out this light, this guy should be in the shadows. Yes, he is. Let me take out... We do not have a civilian scan, that is sad. Diversion cam and a stick... Oh yeah, right here, stick cam. I forget sometimes that it's called a sticky cam, not a surveillance cam. Oh, there's a guy that goes there. I see. I had not realized that before. So I can basically just put this guy down here. And he'll be fine. No one should be able to detect where he is. And yeah, before I make a move ahead. Saving again. I can play a little more aggressively now that I'm using like a first person mod here, like playing it like a shooter. I just hope that I don't get spotted here. I most likely will.
Get another bottle.
Hell no, I don't want to get blown up.
And why are my chances any better than yours?
Because you helped lay the traps.
Not all of them. Besides, they're easy to spot. Just look for the trip wires.
I can't look for trip wires. I'm drunk.
I drank as much as you did.
So that should make you braver. Remember, you need to fix the broken mine.
Yeah, I'll do it now.
I'm just waiting for one of them to step on the landmine and die. Ah, this guy. Ah, yes. Why don't you come to check on your friend, and I'll kill you too. Of course he's not. Neither are you gonna be soon. I wonder if I have to hide those bodies in... what is essentially... the foliage here. Before I go further, I would just like to make an emergency backup save here. Right here. Right. So the thing is, the way this game is designed, you just need to hide all bodies inside, you know, in the shadows. Should you fail to do that, you will get, like, it'll raise the alarms. Doesn't matter if the body's hidden in the foliage or anything else. I've not really experimented with what happens if you don't hide the body in the foliage. Like, if you hide the body in the foliage, I mean, it's the first time I am knocking anybody out in this game, but yeah, just one of the ways that this game is finicky. I hope they're in the foliage. At any rate. They're like two wires right here. Oh, how do I get past them? I think I need to disarm at least one of them. No way I'm getting past both of them without disabling one of them. Better to have your NVGs equipped in this level. Because otherwise you're in for a lot of surprises. I mean, your thermal vision. Oh, okay, I see a person there. But before I go ahead and take him out, Yeah, that makes sense to me. Oh, okay. Careful there. Quick saving here. Just for the sake of quick saving. We need to drag this body across somewhere. Like somewhere out of the way. Where it's completely dark. But from the looks of it, I think we can dump the body right here. I mean, the cursor is blinking, so it must be fine, I guess, to just dump it right here. Or so I guess. I mean, it doesn't really get better than this, to be honest. Quick saving again. Whoops. Not what I meant to do, but okay. Yeah, the thermal vision mode lets you see much more than your eyes can see. It really is a godsend. A blessing. So yeah, we're gonna have to go around this way. That didn't work out. So yeah, I guess I'm gonna have to disable this one then. That got disabled relatively easily. I do believe there was one more guy over here. Somewhere over here. He should be somewhere here. No? There should have been one more person here. Oh, wait. I guess we saw one more person there because we didn't take out the first guy. So there were only two people patrolling here, I suppose. Well then, that's good. Maybe I'll save. Save too. Let's override the save. Yeah, we cleared. There are no more landmines up ahead. It's just this one section.
You should be close to Sedano's plane, Fisher.
Really?
I'm gonna try using the smoke grenade here. Let them finish
shocking. Is the plane ready to go?
No, we're still waiting.
Get her!
Okay. That was not what I intended to do, but yeah. That's how it turned out. So we'll just leave it at that. What we will do instead, however, is go upstairs and turn off the lights. I hope nobody walks in at this moment. And we just need to do something about... Yeah, they're still in the light. We need to put them in the shadows instead. See, that's the worst part about playing this game like this. Is the fact that you need to keep hiding the damn bodies. Hopefully this is out of the way and that nobody's gonna come here looking for them. If they do, well, I'm sorry. But your friends are dead. I sort of tried using the gas grenade to my advantage, but yeah, like you guys saw, it doesn't exactly work out the way you want it to. Now there's gonna be one more guy that opens the door as soon as we're done. So we just need to be sort of ready. Just walking about. I can hear somebody just walking about. Anyway, must just be the soundtrack. Wasn't it? Oh wait, is it near the engine or the wing or someplace? Should be some. Yeah, right here.
Good work, Fisher.
I have no idea. Why don't you come and find out?
I'm taking...
No, you're not. You're taking nothing. Okay. As long as they're all in the shadows. Let me just go and reload my gun. I've still got like 136 rounds left, which I do believe is a lot of rounds.
I've got an allergic reaction to machetes, which makes me a firm Dara Dandoa supporter.
I'm glad to have Sadono here. Suddenly feels like we have a cause beyond money. Somebody to follow.
Yeah. But really? So many executions.
It's only a process of refinement. Productivity is up, security is tighter. Just keep yourself useful and patriotic so you don't end up on the chopping block.
That's one way to put it. Now why don't you come over here so that I can shoot you in the head? Yeah, come on. I think both of you are in the shadows. Good. Let me just take out this light here. And, well, let me quick save first. And then, well, I hate to do this, but it's gotta happen. We need to do something about this dog here. And its handler, not just the dog. Safe thus far. I guess they're in the shadows enough. Come on.
Security stage increased. Stage one. Flak jackets on.
Alarm stage one. Sam, don't be detected.
Be careful, Fisher. Stealth skills are crucial for this operation.
I will try my best. There should be another guy up top. Yeah, we just need to take this guy out too. And I don't think there's anybody else in this entire level. I think we're set. Like, a part of this level involves... the next section will be about tailing Sadono, so yeah. We're just gonna have to be a little careful there. Let me just put this body here. I do not think it really matters, but still. This is guy in the shadows, yes he is. Let me go ahead and reload. I mean, the alarms are going to be reset as soon as we hit the next section, so... Anyway, do I need to save here? I do not think I do. I'm pretty sure we can make do with another alarm here. Yeah, unfortunately we can't really do anything about this guy, because as soon as we grab the zipline, it'll cause another alarm, so... Yeah... it's sad, but it is what it is. Oh wait, unless we put him into like this corner here. I mean, we tried, right? Like, this section is about trailing Sadono. So, yeah, I don't know how it's gonna go.
I'm inside the camp.
The core of your mission is Sadono. He's on site. We need you to locate and trail him. But again, don't let him spot you.
Pandora Tomorrow?
That's the idea. We haven't been able to trace his daily insurance call remotely, so we're gonna need you to get in there with a tap. Fifth Freedom with Sadono Militia. But don't get spotted before tapping the phone. Updates on your OPSAT.
Roger, roger. I'm just gonna wait right here. Because this guy is smoking a cigarette here, Sadono. That guy right there. If you could take him out right now, it would be so easy.
It is, sir. Things are going good.
Let me just go and read whatever's written here. Data stick. Yeah, I dislike how we have the background for, you know. Essentially, we have a background there, so we can't read much of whatever is being said. Somebody there. That makes things easier. pick the body up. I mean, Sadono's gonna wait for you, so it's okay. You can take your time picking the bodies up. And I just hope that one guy is in the shadows. If he isn't, well, too bad. I can afford to get one alarm anyway. Yeah, typically we're supposed to just follow this route here. And basically just follow Sadono. But yeah, let's see how that goes. Pulling out my rifle again. I wonder what the button for changing the fire rate was. Was it F? Yes, it was. Although I personally find that... Single fire mode is better.
Of course. Sadono changes the passcode for entry twice daily. He doesn't write it down. He gives it verbally to his three top lieutenants on site.
So I grab one and make him talk.
No. We need to stay discreet. We can't afford to have Sadono panic and skip a call. Use the sticky cam to overhear those
conversations. Right.
Conversations. Details on your opsat.
You can use your sticky cam to overhear the code.
How does it go?
Real good. We're ahead of schedule.
On?
Product.
We'll meet tonight.
Doesn't make sense!
Spotted by Sadono. Like, this section is easily the most difficult part. Like, just climbing up there. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. But it's okay, it happens to the best of us. So, we need to walk as slowly as possible here. I'm not going to be using that. I wonder what's here. Nothing? Nothing. Anyway, since this is like a touchy situation, I didn't exactly target Sadono's militia. Otherwise, I would have done just that. And we can just walk right past. We don't really need to do anything here. That is, I do believe, where we come in from. And this is where we have to go. That is where Sadono walks through. So we can pretty much go through the store as well. We just need to be careful not to walk into Sadono, that's all. Or we can go along the other side of the wall there. But in that case, we are sort of, you know, we are at a risk of getting caught by Sadono. Yeah, and this is one of the trickier sections of the game.
Good afternoon. I'm worried about the men.
How so?
I want to make sure they're not using the product.
I don't think they would. They're all good boys.
Yes. We'll arrange for a spot check tonight, just the same.
All right.
Today's code for headquarters is 1492. Got it?
Yes.
Good.
There's a colonial home overlooking the compound at the end of the village. That's where Sadono makes his Pandora Tomorrow phone call. That's where you'll need to be to tap it. Trail him, so you'll be sure to be there on time.
Roger. I'll just go ahead and kill this guy here. I'll... try to make it be in the swim. For him, of course. Not for anybody else. Oh, there's a doggy there. Wait, where's the other guy? Oh, right. Do I need to kill this guy? Sure, why not? Like I said, I don't really like doing it, but just to be on the safer side, you know. So when I think about playing a game in a tactical shooter kind of way, I think about getting into shootouts, not doing what I'm doing right now, killing people from the shadows and yeah, essentially pussyfooting about the map. I think about getting into actual shootouts, but I guess that isn't always possible. There was one of these dogs here. I suppose that takes care of the dog. I suppose there should be more.
I'm concerned about security.
We're in good shape. Though I wish you would stay out of plain sight.
Don't worry, I'm fine. Bullets can't find me.
Yes, but...
any risk is worth the confidence my presence gives our men. And the anxiety it causes the West. Have you seen the news reports lately?
I don't watch TV.
Come up to the big house tonight. I'll show you the news. They think I'm the devil himself. Today's passcode is 1492.
Yes, sir. 1492.
So in case you fail to catch the code the first time around, you can essentially catch it from here. So I'm just gonna let Sadono move along there before I decide to kill his henchmen. Wait, diversion camp smoke grenade. Maybe I can try using the smoke grenade again. I'll just let Sadono move along though first. Like, move along first though. What's strange? The sticky cam? Oh no.
What have I been killed?
Nope. Nothing happened. Everything's fine. Everything is under control. Come on. Time for you to go into the corner like a good little boy. Now the cool thing about sticky cams and the like is that you can actually pick them up. And this level also has this weird knocking sound which comes from the right hand side. And yeah, it just feels weird to me because I always think like there's somebody rapping at my door. At 2 o'clock in the night. Which is eerily, you know. Which is pretty eerie, if you ask me. So, yeah, I just found it pretty strange that this level has that sound. But anyway, whatever floats your boat, right? Trail intercepts the bonus communications.
Got a heads up for you from Grim.
We're going to be losing touch in a second. There must be copper coils or some kind of grid ahead of you. The refinery proper is a dead signal hole. Good luck with your airplane, pilot.
We're going to be out of contact as long as you're underground.
I'll try not to get too lonely.
So let me just switch over the pistol here and start reading some of the data. Okay, this is the guy that we need to meet up with. And... yeah, we drove them back. I saw the back of many American helmets today. We lost only 3 men, and though we found no corpses, killed a half dozen American at least. Sadono was there, I'm sure. I did not see him, but everybody was talking about it. Halfway through the fighting, the Americans turned as suddenly as a flock of birds. the most incredible thing I've ever seen. Sadono is without fear, and that fearlessness is infectious. I tremble to think we may actually win. S. Sugeng to Kabri. Palembang. Victory in Palembang. I wonder what they said. From Billy to Raja. American reports. Homsi. Yes, Sadono hates it too, but when I call myself Sadono hates it too when I call myself a secretary, but no matter how brilliant a leader he is, the man types like a trained chicken. His response to your messages of April 8th dictated yesterday afternoon. The Springfield, Texas smallpox vaccinations, obviously not so deliberate, desirable as an actual outbreak would have been. But we can be certain we have the world's attention, or at least that of US intelligence. He pauses for laughter, ironic, not maniacal. Sot's resources tell us that the CIA is well aware of our insurance policy. All but one of our policies are in place and ready to be released upon a day's silence. We will not need to make another demonstration. Any further action will be the attack itself. I suppose. And from what I hear... Okay, that's the wrong spelling there. It's working. Sadono suddenly seems impervious to bullets. Even the American-controlled media seems like it. Seems like it can't help but paint him as a hero. Talk to you soon, BM. Right. Saving here. Yeah. Saving here. What the hell indeed. I wonder where that guy is. Is he heading up? Is he still down there? Oh yeah, he did head up. Well, thank you for coming. That was my TED talk. Not much of a dialogue there, but it was still what it was. Pretty good. And I do believe that is... Well, not apparently it's not heroin yet, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be heroin soon. Optic cable. Oh yeah, this section. I intend on killing those guys as well. I just hope that none of these guys decide that they need to trigger an alarm. Because the correct way to do this is just, you know, switch this object, go through the middle, and you're golden. See, one of the things about the rifle is that while it is amazing for firefights, it leaves like a huge trail.
He's been killed!
Well, since we're gonna... Since it's gonna be a firefight anyway, might as well. I was hoping that it would not be a firefight, but apparently these guys had other plans. So, alright. I'll accommodate your plans. So yeah, one of the things about the rifle is that while it is excellent for firefights, it just sucks for, you know, discreet shooting, because it's just too loud. I mean, I think it uses supersonic ammunition, 5.56 NATO rounds, I think that those are supersonic. I mean, of course, it depends on the powder load as well, but I do believe that those are supersonic rounds. But the 5.57 that the pistol uses, I do believe that they're subsonic ammunition, based on what I read somewhere. So, yeah. Seems safe. So I guess Sadono's here, so we just need to be a little careful with our, you know...
Is the plane alright?
It's almost ready to go.
Go! Don't waste more time.
Alright. I won't. I pray you don't either. Sadono went through that door. That guy's dead. Simple enough.
Somebody shoot!
Simple enough. If I say so myself. I mean, that was badly executed, not good aim at all. But yeah, let me hide this body in the shadows. Move it to the shadows instead. Yeah, that's more like it. At any rate, talk to me.
Eternal dirt.
Thank God you found me, ignominious getaway.
I'm short on time. What do I need to know?
This name, Stanley Nakaryakov, Golden Triangle affiliated. He lives in the Lei Yuman district of Hong Kong, but don't broadcast it electronically. This part of the world is made of ears.
My encryption is solid.
I wouldn't count on it. There's more to Japan's ISDF than they're letting on.
How do you know?
I've seen two other CIA resources disappear.
So how do you know it's the ISDF?
Money knows everything. The name is Stanley Nakaryakov. Got it?
Yeah. Just one piece of advice. Don't take your plane.
So, thing is, it's sort of like setting up this, how do I put it? The story for Chaos Theory here, because this snippet right here, Japan's ISD, of something being wrong with it, is essentially what Chaos Theory deals with. So, since they're talking about it, well, that's pretty much what we're going to face in Chaos Theory. I think it was 10623, really? Now, I wonder how I figured out that password. Yeah, that's Sadono's lackey trailing him.
Welcome back to Fresh Air.
Do you have the name?
Fisher. Go tap that phone. We'll talk about the names later.
Notes. Villa today is 1492. Yeah, we... Inventory, of course. Wait, pistol? I think it tells you whether it, what kind of ammo it uses. However, we can't exactly see that right now. Anyway, regarding Sadono's Golden Triangle affiliation, Stanley Nakaryakov, I wonder who that is. I wonder if that's the name we're gonna come across in Chaos Theory.
Seriously, they're ringing!
Nag, nag, nag.
I'm a musician, my ears are very sensitive. Why do they always give us this patrol?
What about me? I've got to listen to the constant gunfire and your constant complaining.
I feel like somebody's kicking me in the head.
Now there's an idea.
At any rate, what I will be doing in this section here is moving along. Like, pretty much just being stealthy. Wait, there was like a pipe that we could climb. Oh yeah, right here. Come on. Good job, Fisher. So yeah, it's like... At this point, I'm just sort of tired of hiding all the bodies, and it isn't like this section is particularly difficult or there's like a lot of shootouts or whatever, it's just there's a lot of enemies, and I'm just tired of hiding all the bodies, to be honest. That's literally it. Now, what I dislike about this is how we can't see anywhere apart from this angle here, because we need to be able to see, like, if you take a proper look, there's a guy down there who's looking right at you, right up at the ceiling as he smokes a cigarette, right at the doorway. So yeah, it's a pretty spine-chilling moment, pretty nerve-wracking moment, especially when we try to... move past this section here. And there's this guy boxing here, but the bag is just so dusty that he keeps coughing every single time he throws a kick. Again, I don't really want to clean up bodies, clean up any of the bodies really, so I'll just take it slow.
Be careful. The access to the house isn't as easy as it seems. You should wait for darkness.
Yeah, the shadow's essentially going to grow the shadow from the tree there. I think that guy's in the shadows. I think that guy too is in the shadows, but before I go ahead and verify, I would like to check what this turret has to say about it all. I mean, I don't exactly want to go disagree with the status here, so I find it to be a bad idea to be in disagreement with that turret. So yeah, we can't exactly go through here. We'll have to go through the security booth there. But something that I do want to do is just take these lights out for the next body that I'm going to be putting here. What happened? Why is there nobody here?
Who did that?
Yeah, come on. Investigate, come here. Come on. Come on here. Come on. Well, that's curious. The spotlight does not... the searchlight does not... decides not to spot this guy's body. Utmost curious. I'll just hide him in here, though. And I'll restore all my health as well. Like, really the only thing you can do here is, the only thing that you should be doing here is avoiding the spotlight. The rest is fine. You can do whatever you want. Just avoid the spotlight. Don't get detected by it. Excuse me. I'll be taking this guy here, picking him up and hiding him somewhere a little.
Code is 0526 5173 337 3889. Pandora tomorrow. Good. Until tomorrow.
I hope that the turret does not shoot me. The bad thing is, we can't exactly 1492. I keep forgetting that I can use the mouse pad, sorry, that number pad.
It's me. Today's code is 0526 5173 337 3889. Pandora tomorrow. Good.
Wait, am I supposed to use this thing here?
It's me. Today's code is 0526 5173 337-3889. Pandora Tomorrow. Good.
I suppose not.
It's me. Today's code is 0526 5173 337 3889. Pandora Tomorrow. Good.
Now, what is this guy doing here? Okay, he's out of the picture. We can get inside from the wall with this. It's like they give us a...
Good work, Fisher.
Sadono doesn't know why the lights went out in his own room, please. He came to check it out and he's like, I don't know what happened. Something probably did. Anyway, for the next area, we'll just equip this and try to take out those bad guys. So this is the closest that we can get to like tactical shooter. Although the next level is hardly tactical in the layout anyway, just a second there.
What was this?
No idea. Are you okay?
Yeah, just electrified.
Brunton has a comm from Shetland. Says the snipers are in position. They're ready to fire. They'll only be able to take out men wearing red dots, so choose your moment carefully.
I wonder what happened. Like, why did I get electrified there? Curious, very curious. I guess it's just one of those trollish things that the developers of this game do. Like, yeah, you can run through this entire section because you already know the game, but they are not really that good to let you do that because, well, electrocuted again? Why? What's going on? Did they have to, like, turn off the power or something? I mean, it's not taking away my health, it's just being an annoyance is what. Strange indeed. Maybe I did have to take out the power source there. At any rate, this is where things get a little bit tricky. There's some more data here. No, no more data. Semi-auto pistol with 20-round magazine and a silencer. Yeah, can't really tell. Anyway.
Fisher, freeze! Don't make a move. Shetland will take you out of there.
I need help! I'm under attack!
Hey, you guys, keep firing at them over there. And I'll take care of these guys here. I'll take care of you guys from behind. Good job, Shetland. Really good job. Where's the Osprey? I can hear it. Oh, there it is. Refinery, Kundang, Indonesia, April 12, 2016. Sorry, 2006. Holy hell, it's been a long time since 2006. I feel old now. 18:15 hours. Mission complete. Grim Sortier traced Sadono's Pandora Tomorrow phone call through several relay points before losing it in a shipyard on an island off the eastern coast of Indonesia. And that's pretty much it. So basically, we're trying to put a tap on Sadono's secure communication, but even that is being bounced all over the place. I mean, the man takes his security seriously, otherwise he couldn't really be the dictator of a rebellion. You have to. But at any rate, that's our next objective. We'll have to go to an island off the eastern coast of Indonesia and check what's up with the signal relay. Why is it not transmitting any further? And if, in case they're using some sort of specialized equipment to, you know, scramble the signal or whatever, we'll need to just put a tap on it. And that's our next mission. so that, you know, we can find a clear line of communication between whoever it is, Sadono, and whoever it is that he's talking to. The funniest part of this level was how Sadono came into his room, saw that all the lights were out, and he's like, I don't know what happened. Anyway, this mission, it wasn't really as different in the first person mod installed. I'm hoping that the next one will, especially since it has a shootout section in it, and the television station, I don't really know what to make of it, because Sadono's aim is pretty good and he hits harder than a sniper being the boss, and also for the final section of that mission again we have to maintain a stealth, and then there's LAX where stealth is mandatory as well. So I guess this game wasn't really designed for shootouts. I'm actually really looking forward to Chaos Theory, because that actually does accommodate a more shooter friendly playstyle and gives you tools for it as well, including like you know, the assault shotgun, the underbarrel shotgun attachment, and other things of that nature. However, speaking of Chaos Theory, we'll be crossing that bridge when we get to it. As for today, this is it for today's video. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time we'll come back, we will be covering the submarine base or the naval shipyard. I don't know what it is called exactly, but it's somewhere in Indonesia. So, until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.